Hi, this is Shop Talk. I'm Lexi Schultz, sitting in for Ria Tanhuat Cotrillo. We end our Holy Week special by talking about the evangelization work of community through their ministry, Preacher in Blue Jeans. Here to tell us more about their group and what they do are Mike Viñas and Jan Silan. Both of them are with the Preachers in Blue Jeans. Mike is also a worship leader while Jan is a feast builder with the Light of Jesus community. Hello guys, thanks for coming into this show. Wow, that was a lot of words to try and understand. You guys are part of a ministry, but maybe we can talk about you guys separately first.
Sure.
Jan, let's talk about you first. You actually gave up everything to be part of this ministry.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about your story.
Well, I graduated at the age of 19 in my school. Then I worked for a call center company for 2 years.
Okay.
Then after that, I shifted career to an IT company and I worked as a software engineer.
Wow.
For 4 years.
Okay.
Then eventually Brother Bo opened a slot for me and he asked for my intention, if I want to serve with him in the Light of Jesus family as one of the feast builders.
So let's talk about Brother Bo and the Light of Jesus. You are both part of the Light of Jesus, and Brother Bo is, I guess, the head lay minister?
Yes.
Yeah, it's the head.
Okay, and what is the Light of Jesus all about?
It's really a Catholic charismatic community. It's really a family of just being open to a lot of different kinds of people. We have a heart to really reach out to the unchurched, or what we say, maybe the irreligious or those who are far away from God.
Those are maybe lost?
Yeah, those who are lost, broken.
But do you tap Catholics primarily that have maybe left the faith?
That's right.
For whatever reasons, or do you try to tap people who have never really been Catholics, but you want to explain to them about your work?
That's actually primarily we're trying to target the 85% of Catholics who don't go to Mass anymore.
Yes.
And then...
Is that a real statistic?
I think...
Wow,
yeah,
that's a
that
big
is.
Statistic,
from
isn't
the,
it?
Yeah, from the last study that we made, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And then a secondary offshoot of that is also just welcoming anyone, in fact, just who are needing hope, needing encouragement, needing inspiration, I guess.
Okay, so with Jan, you left all of that. You were in IT, you did call center. You're pretty much inculcated into the community already.
Yes, yes.
In the business aspect, but I guess you wanted to do something more.
Yeah, I want to do what I love to do. Then I'm still 26 right now, and I just... I just wanna express my talent through preaching, and I just wanna thank Brother Bo for giving me a chance also to work for his ministry.
Okay. Yeah. Well, you are full time.
Yes.
But you are part time, Mike.
That's right.
Maybe
yes.
Let's talk about your story. What do you do?
Apart from my ministry work as a preacher, as a worship leader in the Light of Jesus family, I also work a full time job, an ordinary guy of 8:30 to 5:30 for Citisec Online. It's an online stock brokerage firm. I do their investment seminars, so I also talk there.
Okay.
I use my God-given gift of being able to speak to an audience, and I also take care of their relationship management group.
But with you, of course, you're also still part of the community, but your story is cute because you decided at one point that you wanted to be a little bit more attached, I guess, to spreading the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
So you prayed.
Yeah,
and
that's
what,
right.
What did God say to you?
When I was younger, it really started because for my parents who also were active in another community, that's how it really started out for me. I grew up in that, I guess, in that
environment. And it was comfortable for you.
That's right, yeah. Mm-hmm. And in a young age, so when I came to know the Lord more in a deeper way, I just found that calling, that purpose to share more of Him to other people, especially to our generation today, and just relate how great God is contemporary, very creative in a modern way. And I love doing that in various means, whether it's preaching, it's through music, worship leading, or maybe just sharing to anyone, just talking to them. Yeah.
And because you're trying to make it a little more contemporary,
mm-hmm.
would you say that your target audience would be the youth? Or is that primary and then you can also reach a broader spectrum?
I guess, yes, we try to be able to somehow format or package our messages in a way in which it's relatable to a certain segment of maybe the youth, but we try to somehow also reach out to a lot of people as long as they want to hear hope, hear encouragement, and hear inspiration. I think it cuts across. I think our needs are not just boxed into just because you're young, but maybe because also a lot of people just also want to hear something that they can latch onto, that can get them through the next day, regardless of age or demographic or anything like that.
Right, and you guys decided to also go 21st century, so you have a broadcast online.
Yes.
And something a little more original called The Preachers in Blue Jeans.
Yes.
Hence the outfit. Buti hindi ako ng jeans today. Baka mapasama pa ako. So maybe you can talk about The Preachers in Blue Jeans. This is within The Light of Jesus.
Yes.
Yes? Mm-hmm. Talk about it, please, Jeff.
It's just an online video wherein we're given around 5 minutes of the maximum to share a portion of our lives. Very practical means of everyday life. It's called Blue Jeans because we want to be preachers, but at the same time, as the jeans represent, everybody wears jeans. So everything's just practical. Everything
it's more
we
relaxed.
Share there. Yes, it's more relaxed.
That's right.
It's more day-to-day. It's more on family, work, how to get promoted, or our struggles with traffic. For example, if someone gets cut up. For example, if I get caught by a bus or something like that, we share it there. Very practical. And thank you for the internet because we're able to evangelize
and reach out to a lot more people.
How did it come about, though? What was it, a project that you had in mind for quite a while? Is it your brainchild, Brother Bo? Whose was it?
Initially, I think back in 2006, it was Brother Bo who came up with the show. I think he wanted to really do it on TV, but because of financial constraints.
Of course.
And I think it was at that time that YouTube was getting bigger. So he used the internet as a medium.
Perfect
somehow.
Vehicle,
yeah,
right?
To broadcast to more people, and it's for free, more at least to that extent. And we would always, at the end of the show, we would always say, this is your dose of everyday spirituality. So it's really, I think, seeing an extraordinary God in ordinary things and just relaying that or sharing that revelation packed with wisdom to be able to, again, reach out and give hope and encourage people around you. I was also thinking about the idea that it was jeans. We all know that jeans is very staple. Everybody has them.
It's approachable,
that's right. And then jeans over the time, I mean, progresses. It evolves from different cuts, different colors,
different
different styles. And I think it's the same thing with what we say. God's word is the same. It's staple. It's there. It's never been changed. It's always been effective. But we repackage it in a certain way that evolves, that's able to reach out and somehow... The young crowd today or someone who's just struggling with a lot of things or can connect to it. Yeah.
Preaching the word, it should not be boring.
Right, of course.
Yeah, that's right.
And jeans are never boring,
yes.
Are they? That's a nice symbolism,
yeah,
isn't
right.
it?
Yeah.
Okay, so you talk for 5 minutes. Maybe you talk about the experiences of the day, but do you end with, like, let's say, a quote from the Bible, or do you tie it up with a certain message of God? How is the structure of the show?
Of course, we first somehow share that experience or that encounter in which we felt God was speaking to us through that ordinary encounter. Like, for example, maybe getting lost in a parking lot or
and
something like that.
Praying to an angel and finding parking.
Yes, yes.
Well, something
he's
like
the
that.
God of creation and he is the God of the parking lot.
That's
you
right.
Usually
we all
that
go
prayer.
Through that, right?
True, true.
And so from there, just relaying that so that we can connect to our audience so that they feel na parang, this is not heavy stuff. This is something
and it's happened
I can
to me
swallow.
Before.
Yeah,
yeah.
I can relate to it.
It's creative.
Right.
It's engaging.
Right.
And then from that, we somehow just try to tie it up with wisdom on what God could say with that perspective, with that situation. And then we ended up with a prayer. It's optional to put in a Bible verse, but as long as it's, again, simple, yet...
Understood
in a very easy way, creative, and then people can just simply...
Appetizing, I guess, to a whole... plethora of audience members.
That when they hear it, they say, well, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do
this.
So with the preachers in blue jeans, because the ministry is not only tied down to men, right? Are there women in the ministry
is it
purely... It's a mix.
It's everyone, really. We have women who serve with us also, and we have women members. But pretty much, I think leadership is... when it comes to leaders, it's more men.
It's more men. Mm-hmm. And so the preachers in blue jeans... Are they all men as well?
Yes.
Do you have any women members? So hindi ako maka-join. No. But why is it that way? Why did Brother Bo structure it that way?
I think it was a strategy that he really thought of, that when it comes to leadership in a ministry, when you have a woman in front, nothing against women really, they're good.
And
in fact, a lot of our servants are women. But when it comes to leadership, when the women is in front, you only attract sometimes women. Practically women. But if you have a man in front, and they speak and they engage with people, they're able to attract both men and women. I mean, you know, men these days, I mean, again, it's somehow doubly hard to reach them out. So
blame it to the pride of men.
Yeah. Doon naman din tayo dati. Yeah.
Chauvinistic society,
perhaps. Ayaw na bin natin. Parang ano yan? Badu, you're
so what are the requirements for to be a preacher in blue jeans?
Well, seeing the video, seeing everyone who's invited, usually they are the preachers in the different feasts in the all around the Philippines and the world.
What is a feast? Sorry. Explain to me what a feast is.
A feast is our weekly gathering.
Okay.
Wherein weekly gathering wherein we play worship, then other feasts they have mass, then there's a talk. A special talk for the in the series.
I guess this is your weekly gathering.
Yes,
would you say that's what it is?
Yes.
Okay.
And it's actually not just in one venue. We have several around the country and even I think around the world.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
All
right. So we'll probably be taking a short break, but we have a lot to talk about with you guys when we come back. All right. So stay with us. Shop Talk. We'll be right back.